Yo, what's going on, guys? My name is Dragon X, and today I'm here with a brand new video. A lot of people ask me for tips and tricks to the stamina one. They ask me, what is a good combo? How can I survive? How can I sustain? And all these questions I answer today in this video. Before we can start with the topic of today, we have to do few basic things. They are very important. Without them, this playstyle isn't working. And we have to go for this into the champion points, and we need 120 points in the Atronach for the tactician passive. Now you can see it already. When you use the wall dodge to dodge an attack, you set the enemy off balance. It's very important. We play a lot with off balance with this playstyle, and we need it. And the second one is 75 points into the ritual for the expert or passive. Increase your damage done against off-balance enemies by 10%. 10% is a lot of damage, and with the extra off-balance with the tactician passive, it's very good, guys. Yeah, this is very important with this build. Without them, it's not working. Let's start with the step one, and the most important thing is the buffs and the debuff. On the warden, we have only one offensive buff. If we're gonna use the 2H, we have two. We have the Netch for the 20% weapon damage increase, or the Momentum if we play 2H. 20% weapon damage is definitely a lot, especially if we play medium, so we have a lot of weapon damage, and 20%, yeah, you feel it. If you don't have it active, you feel definitely that you lose a lot of damage. But I think all of you know it anyway, also for the defense parts of the Netch, yeah, it's a good skill that should be active the full time. Yeah, the Netch should be active the full time, most important thing is that. And the second thing is, and this is only working if you focus one guy or maybe two guys. It's not if you're fighting a Zerg. If you're fighting a Zerg, you can't use it, or you can't drop it on all of them. It's the Swarm. The Swarm is very good. It gives you an 8% damage increase on your enemy, and all your teammates in your group dealing also 8% more damage on this person. So check it that you have it active, or maybe on a tanky guy, or if you're fighting a small group, you can pick one guy, put a swarm on him and focus him for your combo, and you deal 8% more damage, and that's definitely a good thing that you can have active on your enemy. And now we come to the first combo, and this is the main combo. This combo we do the most of the time. And after this I show you also a clip with the off balance against Nuevo. This is more different, but first I'm gonna show you the combo without the off balance, and yeah, it's working very easy. We put the swarm on the enemy, for sure we check we have our buff active, we put the swarm on the enemy, then we use the momentum, we're shooting a bird, and we can do heavy attack or light attack and dawnbreaker, and after we can spin them if they're on the ground, and that's dealing a lot of damage, and it's very easy. Yeah, I do it again without dawnbreaker now, buff up, put the swarm on the enemy for the 8% more damage, put the sub assault, shooting a bird, and we can do a heavy attack and spin. You can also do a light attack there, depends on the situation. The good thing is, and this is the part with the off balance, if we have the enemy off balance and we're doing a heavy attack, you don't have to do a fully charged heavy attack. You can cancel the heavy attack also a bit to stun him and put a downbreak on him so he can't dodge the downbreak or something, can't block it if he's stunned. This is the difference between the off balance combo and the not off balanced one. Now we come to the second thing. After I showed you the main combo, there's a second combo that you can do to deal a bit pressure on the enemy. You don't use your ultimate for this. You can drop your sub assault, and most time you use this if you're a bit far away from the enemy, for example, and you can use sub assault and shoot like two birds. Sub assault, two birds. Sub assault, two birds. You can also put your swarm, sub assault, two birds. And this is a small combo to deal a bit pressure on enemy, and then you can go there and deal your downbreaker combo. The next combo that I'm gonna show you guys is the combo if a Zerg is following me and I run around objects, run away from a Zerg. Let's see, this Atronach is the Zerg. Okay, this is the Zerg now. The Zerg is following me, and there's a nice thing that we can do, and you should learn this, it's an easy cancel. You can cancel your sub assault with a dodge roll. Press the sub assault and dodge roll. You see it, my sub assault appears, With no animation of my skill, so the people can't see so good that I'm dropping my sub sword. So I gonna. If the Zerg is following me, the archer is not the Zerg that is following me. I run away. Use also my anti-stun potion. Drop the sub sword, dodge roll, turn around, and give them a Dawnbreaker combo. And then, if you have luck, yeah, and you can check it, yeah, if you can see it, they are maybe not buffed, they're following you, they are hungry to follow you, they are not buffed. You can use this combo, yeah, drop a sub sword, dodge roll, bam, Dawnbreaker, and they. You surprise them, you surprise them. That's a good thing. If they are not buffed, you deal a lot of damage on them. And it's a good thing to surprise your enemies and you put them also off balance. Because if you dodge roll here from the passive, some of them are off balance, some of the Zerg, and you deal 10% more damage. They get stunned from the Dawnbreaker and you can spin them after this. Now we come to the second part of this video, and this is the defense playstyle, and we start with the healing. How to heal on a warden. The most important thing is, if our heal drops down, very down, we are on super low health, 20% health. The first thing that we do is we don't spam Wigo or something. The first thing is that we're using twice the burst heal. Why twice? With the first heal, we proc the passive. The passive gives us 25% more healing done for 3 seconds. And the heal is not so strong, it's okay. But if we have the 25% buff, then it's strong. And if we are completely low on health and we spam it twice, we are directly on full health. We spam it twice, and then here we go. Or you can also do, if you see you are already have a good heal health after the first heal, and you can use it once and then the Wigo. And the Wigger is also stronger with the passive. But if you are super low on health, use it twice to get full health. Block, yeah, you can block to mitigate the damage. But if you're low on stem, you shouldn't block. Maybe you need the stem to break free or dodge roll. And the next thing is for sure, check that your buffs are up. Yeah, your resistance buff, for sure. For the resistance, your Natch for a bit more sustain. And it cleans also one negative effect every 5 seconds. And your Shuffle for the 25% damage mitigation from AoE skills, and it gives you 4 seconds or 5 seconds immunity against slows and snares. And check that you have these 3 things up, yeah? The Natch, the resistance buff, and the Shuffle. Now we come to a small thing with the Natch. The Natch cleans every 5 seconds one negative effect, but we can abuse this. We can use this also for a spammable. I use it often. For example, the Zerg is here. The Zerg is here and you run around the object. You run around, and while you run around and you have maybe a bit damage on you, some debuffs, you can run around and spam the Natch. You can run around, spam the Natch, jumping around, spam the Natch, and you can clean with every Natch one debuff. So if you have a lot of debuffs on you and maybe also a bit damage on you, because the Natch, if you spam it, it gives you also a small heal. You see from the passive here, it gives you in PvP like 600, 700 health. So if you run around here and you spam it, you can clean yourself from some debuffs and heal a bit. You can also drop it sometimes in the fight, yeah? If you have a strong debuff on you, for example the Atro from the Necro, you should dodge away from the Atro, and if you have the debuff, use the Natch a few times to clean it, because the Atro debuff, for example, is the debuff that you definitely have to clean. You get so much more damage, also with some heal debuffs. Yeah, if you see you have a heal debuff on you, you can try to clean it, and then you can heal. Okay guys, that was a small explanation to my Warden playstyle. For some pro players, maybe it wasn't so interesting, but I think for beginners and for some people that want some tips, they may be new on this class, whatever, and they need some tips, maybe it helps them a bit with the class, yeah, to learn the class. And yeah guys, if you think the video was helpful and you like it, then drop a like, write a nice comment and say what was the good thing that you like. And if you still have some questions, then you can also ask me in the comments. I try to answer them all. And yeah guys, that was the video. Have a nice evening, day, whatever. We see us in the next video. See ya!